In the digital world, we have access to new content, new friends, and new stories at our fingertips. But what about in the physical world? One New York City store is making constant change a reality by using its shelves as a media channel to tell a new story every few weeks.
They're seeing a space that I describe as one that has the point of view of a magazine. We reinvent it entirely every 3 to 8 weeks like a gallery, and we sell things like a store. So what they see 1 month will be very different than what they see 3 months later or 2 months later.
Just because the store is ever-changing like a social media platform doesn't mean it's only for millennials.
I always say our demographic's very narrow. It's men, women, and kids between 5 and 95. And what I mean by that is, like, obviously when we're doing his story about men's grooming, those men have friends and children and partners and girlfriends and boyfriends. And so if you want them to stay longer in the store, I need to figure out a way to engage people who they're with to keep my target here longer. So really we focus on, you know, how we have something for everyone.
The majority of the stories are sponsored, and those sponsors help determine what story will be told.
We ask ourselves 3 questions in terms of determining who we work with and how we partner with them. It's A, do we like them? B, do they bring authority and authenticity to the subject matter and category in which they exist? And C, can we build a compelling and engaging story for men, women, and kids between 5 and 95?
Once a collaboration is born, Story's creative team develops a theme and presents it to the sponsor. Story uses the sponsor's objective to determine the types of events, activities, and merchandise that will be sold in the store to create an experience that is unique for every consumer.
It's really looking at what's the best way to tell that story, right? Have fun is an action, right? Like, I'm having fun doing X or Y. So I think it would have been a big miss if we didn't have Tatley temporary tattoo parlor and also a ping pong table and all these other things that you could do in the store. Whereas, you know, the last story was the F-word story on feminism. We decided to make it about written content and using merchandise as a tool to get people's attention, to have conversations around certain subject matters.
Naturally, another interactive element to Story is its online presence.
We live in both worlds, a physical one and a digital one. And so I think making sure that we're sharing content, whether it's something that, you know, our editorial team puts out there into the universe, or whether it's, you know, consumers who come in the store and neighbors and friends who share stuff online.
It's that accessibility for consumers and creators that makes Rachel most excited about the future of Story.
One of the things that I'm most excited and proud about is really how the store has become like a living press release meets a trade show for all these emerging brands and designers and small businesses. It's really about being an engaging community where there's something for everyone.
Kelly Bowman, CNN, New York.